Yes.
Hello, dear professors and attendees. I am Nurbani Yiğit from Düzce University, Türkiye, the Department of Early Childhood Education, and I am here to present our paper with dear Associated Professor Elçin Yazıcı Arıcı and Özgün Uyanık Aktulun. And the paper's name is The Effect of BEP 2.0 Supported Geometry Activities on Children's Geometry Skills. Thank you in advance for your listening. So let me start. Sorry. Before I start, let me show you my presentation outline. It includes introduction, significance and purpose of the study, methodology, findings and discussion, and final recommendation. And I will start with introduction part. Sorry. Young children begin to acquire mathematical knowledge during their daily life experiences in natural course of their development. And therefore, before starting to formal education, children have mathematical knowledge and thoughts. And studies indicate that the development of children's mathematical skills in early childhood is effective in their mathematical success in the following years. And moreover, developing children's geometry skills at an early age plays a fundamental role in children's future mathematical success. And it has been revealed that children participating in geometry activities can think more critically and creatively and develop positive attitudes towards mathematics because they find geometry fun. And as children's geometry knowledge and skills developed, their logical reasoning and ability to solve real life problems developed. And according to most of the studies, the educational programs applied to improve the geometry skills of children in early childhood period are effective in developing their geometry skills and gaining geometric concepts. But on the other hand, it is thought that there is a still need for new education program based on different approach and using different teaching methods for geometry education in early childhood period. And within the scope of this study, we aim to support the geometry skills of preschool children with Web 2.0 supported geometry activities as a different teaching methods for children. So what is this 2.0 supported geometry activities? Let's have a look at it. It refers to the use of interactive web-based tools and resources to support the teaching and learning geometry. And Web 2.0 technologies are characterized by their user-centered design, interactivity, and social collaboration feature. And when evaluated in terms of appealing to children multiple senses, motivating them to their learning process and increasing their curiosity and desire, Web 2.0 technologies used as educational materials in activities make a positive contribution to the child's learning process. So what can be the positive aspects of these activities on preschool children? And these activities can help preschoolers develop spatial thinking skills, such as recognizing shapes, size, orientation, and positions. And these are the important to develop as they form the foundation for more advanced geometry skills later on. And these activities can also provide preschoolers with opportunities to practice problem-solving skills. And they are also customers to meet the individual needs and interests of them. And lastly, using these activities can help preschoolers develop important technology skills, such as navigating the digital platforms and using basic software application. And this study is also important because all geometry activities were created by considering the Van Hyl geometry thinking model. And this model is designed to explain how children learn and understand geometry, and it provides a developmental sequence of geometry thinking. And as they engage geometry activities, and it proposed 5 levels of geometric thinking: visualization, analysis, abstraction, deduction, and rigor. And this model suggests that effective instruction in geometry should be tailored to the children's current level geometry thinking and should provide opportunities for exploration, discovery, and communication of geometric ideas. And in line with this model and considering the need for educational program based on the different approach or using different teaching methods for geometry education and the positive aspect of Web 2.0 supported geometry activities, the current study aims to reveal the effects of Web 2.0 supported geometry activities on the geometry skills of 61 to 66 months old children who attending the kindergarten. And for this purpose, answers to the following questions were sought. Is there a significant difference between early geometry skill test, pre-test and post-test mean scores of the experimental and also control group of children? And is there a significant difference between the EGSD, pre-test, post-test mean scores of the children in the experimental and also control group? And is there a significant difference is the post-test scores of experimental and control groups when the effects of the pre-test scores is removed? Now, I will continue with the methodological part. As a research design, a quasi-experimental design with pre-test, post-test control group was used, and two of the ready-made groups were matched in terms of geometry skills without using random assessment. And the purpose of this is test the cause and effect relationship between these variables. And the our study group is the research consists of randomly selected children who attend the kindergarten affiliated to Ministry of National Education in Aydın, Turkey, and who are not receive this geometry education before. And there are a total 40 children, including the experimental and control groups. And our data collection tool is general information form and the early geometry skill test. And this test was developed Cesar and Güven in 2016 for determining the geometric thinking skills of children age 5 to 7 years. And the content of this test, there are questions based on measuring the skills of choosing a shape, knowing shape feature, drawing shape, continuing the pattern, taking perspective, and such that. And when you look at these geometric activities feature, we can see that these all activities mainly consist of mathematical activities, but they are integrated with different activity types, and they are ranked from easy to difficult, and also they are play-centered, and they planned to carry it out for 10 weeks, 3 days a week, and for approximately 45 to 50 minutes. And this application are carried out the smart board, the teacher's computer, and also the tablet in the classroom. And the children work on these applications individually or as a group. And also parent involvement activities are prepared in accordance with the nature of the activities. And for data collection, for collect the data, first the researchers applied EGSD to experimental control group and the pretest as a pretest. And while these geometry activities were applied to the children in experimental group, the children in control group continue their usual education. And after application, EGSD was applied to children in experimental and control group as a post-test score. And for the data analysis, the data showed a normal distribution in each group. And for this reason, we used a parametric test. The significance of the difference between the mean scores obtained from the independent sample t-test and paired sample t-test. And in addition, ANCOVA was conducted to determine whether the difference between the post-test scores of the experimental and control groups after the experimental procedure was dependent on the pre-test score. Now I will continue with the findings parts of the study. And regarding the comparison of the pretest scores and control, pretest scores of the control and experimental group, you can see that there is no statistically significant difference between the pretest mean scores obtained from the EGSD. So it can be thought that these children in the experimental and control groups are similar in terms of measured characteristics. And regarding the comparison of pretest and post-test scores of the experimental group, it is seen that the difference between the mean scores is quite high, as you can see. And these results show that these Web 2.0 supported geometry activities applied in the experimental group have a strong effect on the geometry skills level of the children. And regarding the comparison of pre-test and post-test scores of the control group, it is seen that there was no significant difference between pre-test and post-test mean scores of control group. And this situation can be interpreted as the methods, techniques, and materials used in the usual education activities applied to control group were not designed to fully support early geometry skills of children. And regarding the comparison of the post-test scores of control and experimental group, it is seen there is a significant difference between the post-test mean scores of groups in the favor of the experimental group. And according to this result, it can be thought that Web 2.0 supported geometry activities revealed a significant difference in children's early geometry skills. And in order to determine whether the difference between the post-test scores of groups was significant or not, covariance analysis was performed by controlling the pre-test scores. And in this analysis, the post-test scores were accepted as a dependent variable, the group constant variable, and the pre-test score as the covariate. And it was determined that there was a significant difference between the post-test scores of the children according to the group variable. And this result showed that when the pre-test scores of the children were controlled, it was concluded that there was a significant difference between the post-test scores in favor of experimental group. And it is shown that the experimental procedure made a significant difference in children's geometrical skills. And lastly, in the light of the data obtained from the research, some educational implication and recommendation can be mentioned. Since Web 2.0 supported activities can be integrated with other activity areas in the early education program, different disciplines can be studied. And by conducting norm studies with Web 2.0 supported geometry activities, a larger sample group can benefit from this training. And digital education tools can be made more known by increasing the number of seminars. And awareness of the importance of these tools in education environments can be created through technology-supported studies with teachers, especially early childhood teachers. And finally, Web 2.0 supported geometry activities can be applied in different age group, in different socioeconomic and cultural environments, and the results can be compared. And finally, these are my reference list. And end of my presentation. Thank you for your listening.